This video tutorial I will explain how to send SMS using AWS SNS without topic in Spring Boot. In this diagram, you can see the user who will trigger the message that will comes to Spring Boot application. Then Spring Boot application send the message to AWS SNS. Then AWS SNS send the message to the particular phone number. We will see how to do that. To implement this, you must have an active AWS account. SNS must be enabled in the region you intended to use, and your account must have SMS capabilities enabled, and you should have IAM user with SNS permissions. Here you can see AWS SNS demo project and its folder structure. Here you can see the pom.xml file. In pom.xml file, I have included the dependencies of Spring Boot Starter Web and AWS SDK for SNS. Here you can see application.properties file, and here you have to provide your AWS access key and your AWS secret key, and you have to specify the region. To know how to create the user, how to create AWS credentials, please check the link in this video description. Here you can see the user. Click on this. Click on Add Permission. Choose Attach Policies directly. Search for SNS. Select the first one, Amazon SNS Full Access. Click on Next. Click on Add Permissions. Permission is added successfully. I have logged into AWS console. Search for SNS. Here you can see the mobile section. Click on Text Messaging. Here you can see sandbox destination phone numbers. I already added my phone number and I have already verified. This step is important, otherwise you won't receive the SMS message. To add new phone number, you have to click on this. Then here you have to provide your phone number. Then verification message language. Then click on add phone number. Then your phone number will get SMS message with the verification code. That verification code you have to enter here. Then click on verify phone number. We'll add the phone number to sandbox environment. Here I have defined the class SNS SMS service, and it is a service class. Here I have defined the SNS client object, and here you can see the constructor which uses @value annotation to read AWS credentials and region from the application.properties file. And using that, here I am creating a SNS client object. Here you can see send SMS method which accept phone number and message. This method is used to send SMS directly to the phone number via SNS. No topic is needed. In this method, I am creating a publish request object using a message and a phone number. Then I am calling a publish method of SNS client object and passing a publish request object. This method returns a publish response object. From that, I am getting a message ID and returning that. Here I have defined the class SNS controller, and it is REST controller, and it exposes HTTP endpoint to send SMS messages. Here I have defined SNS SMS service, and here I am using a constructor based dependency injection to inject SNS SMS service object, and it has a send SMS method which accept phone number and message. And here I am calling send SMS method of SNS SMS service object and passing phone number and message. And to call this method, we have to use HTTP method as post, and we have to use this HTTP endpoint with this request parameters. Here I have defined the class AWS SNS Demo Application, which is a Spring Boot application. Now I am going to start this Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot application has been started in 8080 port. Here you can see the postman, and I am using this URL, and here you can see the phone number and the message. HTTP method I have selected as post. Click on send. And here you can see the SMS sent successfully. Here is the message ID. Check the SMS in the phone. You might be received the hello message. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click on like button and please subscribe to my channel. You can get Java source code and PowerPoint presentation for each and every video. That you can see it in the description section of the video. Click on show more, and here you can see the description, and here you can see the links to download source code and PowerPoint presentation.